In the previous video, we looked at how services are implemented in Kubernetes and how they allow accessing applications from within and outside the cluster. In this short video, we will look at how services are implemented by Kubernetes. When you create a service that has a selector, the selectors are evaluated and any pods that match them are added to the endpoints object. The endpoints object are the interface between the service and the pod. That is, they tell the service where the pods are. For a service that does not have a selector, the endpoints have to be manually maintained. Next, let's look at how requests to services are routed. Each node has a component called kubeproxy. There are three modes in which kubeproxy works: user space, IP tables, and IPVs. The default is IP tables, and I'll explain how that works. For each service, kubeproxy captures TCP, UDP and SCTP traffic and forwards it to one or more backends by load balancing across them. Kubeproxy does this by changing the IP tables on the node for each service. In the IP tables mode, kubeproxy watches the API server for additions to services and endpoints. When it sees a new service, it adds an entry in the IP tables which directs the traffic for that service to the service's backend. Similarly, it adds an entry for the endpoint to select a backend pod. When a user or application accesses the service, IP tables routes that request to the appropriate backend. To see this in action, we can log into Minikube and look at the IP tables entry. Let's take a look at the static website service. The cluster IP ends with 90, the node port is 30500, and endpoints end with 6 and 7. With that in mind, let's log into Minikube. To log into Minikube, type in minikube.exe/ssh. Change to root by typing in su. To look for entries for static website service, type in IP tables save pipe grep static website service. This will give you all entries that the kubeproxy has made for the service. We can trace through the call by following the rules. When a service hits the node port at port 30500, it is forwarded to the rule that ends with 6RU. This rule and the rule after it randomly selects a backend ending with R7 or 5E. If you follow R7, it says perform a network address translation and forward the packet to a pod that ends with .6. I hope that you have a clearer understanding of how kubeproxy accomplishes packet routing using IP tables. Each service is assigned a unique cluster IP. The IP table rules are updated on all the nodes and hence the traffic can be routed to any pod even if it is on a different node, since the request to the node is ultimately translated to a request to a pod IP. We have already seen that the pod IPs are unique within the cluster and can be reached from anywhere within the cluster without NATing. This finishes our detailed analysis of how services work. Services work at layer 4 of the networking model. In the next video, let's look at ingress, which works at layer 7. See you in the next video.